snipe, I can see the way you're working in me since I've been saving. Old passed away, new is my name.
Praise the Lord. Praise God. We are back. Amen. It's been a while since we have done a video. Amen. For over 3 years, we were doing the encouraging word. And you got used to seeing my face in front of the camera. But now you're able to see the beautiful face of my wife. Amen.
Praise
who's
the Lord.
Come from behind the camera. And who is now joining me here. And God has birthed a new thing in us, and it's called to the glory of God. And what He is birthing in us, He's going to develop and grow. But as of right now, God has called us to speak about His glory.
Yes.
And how important it is for us to live a life that is to the praise of His glory. And so we're just going to follow the Lord, amen, as He leads us.
Yes.
And we believe that the Lord knows what He's doing. And as the Bible says, Jesus does all things well.
Yes.
And so we're believing that He will do this well in through us. And so today we're going to start this first segment, praise God, of To the Glory of God, in Numbers chapter 14, verse number 21. Let's read that together. Mm-hmm. It says, but as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. God makes it plain right there that He says, the whole earth is to be filled with my glory. And that's what's on His mind. That's His purpose. I'm going to fill the whole earth with my glory.
Yes.
And in Isaiah 43, He said that He created His children. Right, for His glory.
Yes.
So if we're created for His glory, and He wants the whole earth to be filled with His glory, then we have to live lives that are that show forth His glory.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So we sort of know that, but we want to take a look at Exodus chapter 33, just to get a little better feel and flavor for this glory of the Lord, because there are so many things that are in church.
Amen.
So many sayings, so many things that we say in church.
Amen.
That a lot of people sort of know but don't quite know.
Yes.
And we don't want that to be the case. We want to know precisely what God is talking about when He's talking about His glory. And let's look at Exodus chapter 33. Let's look at 18, verse number 18. Moses and God are having a conversation.
Yes.
And it says here, and He said, this is Moses saying, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. And God said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee.
Yes.
Amen. I will make all my goodness pass before thee. And so God then, you know, He hid Moses in the cleft of a rock.
Yes.
And He didn't allow him to see his face,
right.
But He allowed him to see his rear parts. But He said, I'm going to let my goodness pass before you. He revealed His goodness unto Moses. And so, for this purpose, we believe that the glory of God is His revealed goodness in the earth. Amen. So God says, I'm going to fill the earth with my revealed goodness. And you and I are created for His glory to be vessels through which His goodness is revealed in the earth. And we're supposed to do that in a whole lot of ways, not just by coming to church.
Amen.
Right?
That's right. Amen. Praise the Lord. God said that He wants His glory to be revealed in the earth, and His goodness is His glory. So we are to reveal His goodness in the earth. And I think that the ways that we do that is how we live.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the goodness of God and how we live and how we how we work and how we do things, how we eat. The scripture in 1 Corinthians, mm-hmm. whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. So whatever yeah. we're doing, we have to bring God, you know, give God glory.
Right. Yeah, that scripture says, you know, whether you eat, drink, or whatsoever right. you may do,
yes.
do all to the glory of God.
Right.
Amen. Amen. So you know what? Getting that extra piece of chicken might not be glory to God. It may not be bringing glory
no,
to God.
No,
amen.
No.
Step away from the chicken. Amen.
Amen.
God says, whether we eat or drink, whatever we do, right? So the way we conduct ourselves, the way we drive our car, the way we answer people,
Jesus.
The way we take care of our homes,
Jesus.
Everything is to show forth God's goodness. And if that's what it's supposed to do, and if we get this in our mind, we will change our conduct.
Amen.
Because now I have to say, did that bring glory to God? Did that show forth that God is good?
Amen.
So when you ask me a question and I snap back at
Jesus.
You, that's not showing the goodness of God in the earth. But being kind, even in response to mistreatment,
yes.
shows forth God's goodness.
And we don't understand that people are watching.
Yes.
People are always watching.
Mm-hmm.
And God says He wants the whole earth to be filled with His glory, to be filled with His goodness. And people see us and they see how we respond to certain things. Then mm-hmm. They're going to know whether or not God is good.
Yeah.
You know, because how we respond. You know, even if you say how you snap back at people.
Mm-hmm.
That does not reveal God's goodness.
No, it doesn't.
But if somebody mistreats you or does something wrong to you, and you respond in a kind way,
mm-hmm.
or you don't respond the way that they expect you to
right.
respond, that shows, okay, something's different here.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the goodness of God that's different.
Right.
That's showing that you believe that God is good and that He should be glorified in everything that you do, say,
thing. Amen. And it's so very important because it's a part of our maturation process. It's part of how we grow and mature in the
yes.
things of God.
Yes.
Because we take it to another level. And see, somebody right now might even be saying, oh, you're being too picky and all that. No, it's not about being picky. God meant it when He said,
the whole earth
shall be filled with my glory.
That's right.
As we were waiting to get started today, God showed me Isaiah chapter 6, verse 3,
mm-hmm.
when Isaiah met God and the angels were singing, holy, 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 and said, the whole earth is filled with His
yes.
glory.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
God is serious about this.
Yes.
God doesn't say something just for effect.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
He says it because He means it. He's not like us. So sometimes we just say things for effect.
Right.
You know, and we exaggerate or embellish. God doesn't exaggerate or embellish. When He said the whole earth is to be filled with, notice what He said, as truly as I live.
Jesus.
Sound like He's serious to me, right?
Amen.
The whole earth should be filled with my glory. So here it is now. And somebody says, oh, you're just being, you know, you're taking it too far. No. If you are living right now, right where you are, you're occupying a place on earth.
Some space. Amen.
Is the space you're occupying right now showing forth the goodness of God? Because that's what He said, the whole earth. That means every inch of it, including the spot that you and I are on right now.
Amen.
The goodness of God should be emanating from this place right here.
Amen.
When I go over there, the goodness of God should be emanating. Amen?
Yes.
That's how it should be. And it will change us from the inside out because we'll say, whoa, whoa, whoa. I can't do what I want.
Yes. You know, this just came to me, and it just, even when we go out, like we go out in public, and we eat, we go mm-hmm. to eat, and we as Christians know that we should give thanks for our food. Now, we go out and we eat, and when someone sees us, you know, say grace before we eat of our food, they have to know that that's a connection with God.
Mm-hmm.
These people are connected to God. God must be so good in their lives that they take a moment to thank Him.
In public.
Yes.
In a restaurant.
For this food. Yes.
Yeah. How many Christians don't?
Yes.
Because they're embarrassed. Oh, they'll pray at home over their
yes.
food. they'll pray among other Christians over their food.
Yes.
They won't even pray in their cafeteria at work.
Oh, Jesus.
Over their food, mm-hmm. because they're not now in a religious setting.
In a religious setting.
God's not looking for religion. He's looking for relationship, and that relationship is ongoing.
Right.
But you're right. Because that even gives glory to God, because
yes.
we're taking time to thank God.
For His goodness and giving us this food. It doesn't have to be that way.
Doesn't have to. Remember that next time you go to Red Lobster. Before they bring them biscuits on the table. You know you love them biscuits.
But you know what? We'd probably be surprised. Talking about biscuits.
Yeah, my mama biscuits.
We would probably be surprised at how many people, you know, when we stop to take a moment to say thank you for this food out in public, how many people get arrested in their spirit. And they weren't going to say grace, but they see you.
Yeah, that's a good thing, though.
And then and that is a good thing. That's why we mm-hmm. never know. We have to realize that it's not about us, it's about God's goodness being revealed.
Yeah. Yeah, and they may be inspired to go on. And that's the thing. When you know, when I see you get mistreated out in public and then you respond with the goodness of God, that's going to inspire me.
Yes.
You know, there's a little commercial out there, I think, I don't know if it's Capital One or something, where they actually show this happening. They show a person across the street and they'll see someone do an act of kindness.
Oh, yes.
And then in the next scene, that person who witnessed it does an act of kindness for somebody else.
Yes.
And that person who was the recipient of it now turns around and does an act of kindness. And,
it's a chain reaction.
Yes, it really is, though. That is the kind of thing that happens in truth.
Yes.
And so, you know, if people see us, you know, bless our food in public, or if you know, we see someone do something that reflects the goodness of God.
Yes.
That's going to inspire us. And like you said, especially if we're not doing it, we go, ooh, because you'll recognize.
Yes.
Goodness can't be denied.
Amen. That's
right?
Right.
Goodness cannot be denied. It can't be faked. It can't be manufactured.
That's it.
When you see true goodness, amen, you know it.
Amen.
And it breaks down all the false things that you and I may be doing and exposes it for what it is. But we can respond to that one of two ways. We can get angry or you say, why they're doing it. Or we can be inspired.
Yes. God said, as surely as I live.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
As surely as I live, the whole earth shall be filled with my glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. And so, but you know what? This is especially important in the church too, because preacher, when you preach a good message, and they say to you, that was a good message, or that was a revelation of God's goodness in the earth, you give God the glory for it.
Amen.
It's not your glory, it belongs to God. He said the whole earth will be filled with what?
His glory.
My glory. That's
right.
What he said, right? My glory, not yours, not mine, not hers. Amen.
Amen.
The only glory in the earth.
Amen.
If the whole earth is filled with God's glory, you know what that means? There's no room for anybody else's glory.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. This is not hard. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This is not hard.
That's it.
There's no room for you and I to have glory.
Yes.
That's important, though, because there's some preachers, there's some soloists and some singers, some psalmists, some musicians, some others who do things in the church.
Yes.
And people praise them because, look, it ministered to them, someone. And that's a blessing.
Mm-hmm.
But that was God's goodness being revealed through the word, through the music, through the song, through the dance.
Amen.
Someone comes up to you and says, man, that really blessed me. Don't say thank you.
Amen.
Don't say I worked hard on this.
Oh, Jesus.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Say, to God be the glory.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Right. Praise the Lord. Don't take glory for yourself. God's not going to share His glory with anybody else. Amen. He didn't say the whole earth is going to be filled with my and your glory.
Right.
Just mine.
That's it. Amen.
And so we have to be careful about this, because that's one way we can miss it. Let's turn for a second to the book of Acts, chapter 12. Because we see this happen with Herod. Acts chapter 12, verse number 21. Because Herod had come out and he had given this great speech.
Yes.
Right? Mm-hmm. Let's read what it says in verse 21. It says, "And upon a set day, Herod, arrayed in royal apparel, sat upon his throne and made an oration unto them." So he made a speech unto the crowd.
Right. Yeah.
"And the people gave a shout, saying, it is the voice of a God and not of man. Mm-hmm. And immediately the angel of the Lord smote him because he gave not God the glory. And he was eaten of worms and gave up the ghost."
Jesus. God doesn't take too kindly to people stealing his glory.
Amen.
God knows he does, you know, he does things for us. He does things through us. He uses us. We ask him to be used of him.
Mm-hmm.
We know that. We know that the Spirit of God is operating us.
Amen.
If we have believed what we prayed when we said,
"Amen,
Lord, use me for your glory." But we know that. So how can we dare, when someone tries to give us the credit for doing something, how can we dare try to say it wasn't God?
Amen. Yeah, we have to make sure we give him the glory for it.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. You know, give glory. And, you know, I joked about this before, but, you know, my wife, amen, if she makes something, it could be as modest as tuna fish, amen. And I say to her, "Yeah, that was some good tuna fish." She'll say, "Praise the Lord," right? That's a way of saying praise the Lord. But that's the way it has to be.
Yes.
Whether you're making tuna fish, whether you're making a cake, whether you're, you know, doing a presentation, praise the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord that he allowed this to come out right.
Amen.
Praise the Lord that it tastes good. Praise the Lord that this worked and it was effective.
Yes.
Praise the Lord that I started mowing my lawn today and I finished.
Amen.
How many of you know it didn't have to happen? Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord I was able to do it. Praise the Lord.
Praise
you know, sometimes
Lord.
I even go running. When I go running, if I run 3 miles, 4 miles or whatever, when I'm done, I say, "Praise the Lord for allowing me to finish." You understand?
Yes.
That's God's goodness.
Yeah.
I went out to run 4 miles and I ran the 4 miles.
Right.
I didn't get a cramp. I didn't, you know, have pain and couldn't continue.
Amen.
That's God's goodness being
yes.
revealed in my
That's
life.
It.
Right?
That's it.
We got to give God the praise and give him the glory. And when we do that, he is pleased.
Yes.
Now, we see with Herod,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yes.
With Herod, Herod gave a nice speech and people were saying, "Oh, it's the voice of a God and not a man." And he just said, "Thank you very
much.
And it says, "And immediately the angel of the Lord smote him and he was eaten by worms from the inside out.
Amen.
And it's funny, now I don't believe, amen, that God is going to smoke his children down immediately from the inside out. But I'm not taking it for granted that he might not.
Right.
That he did
right.
it to Herod,
right.
amen. But here's the thing. Understand, Herod was eaten from the inside out.
Yes.
You know what? Now, he might not put worms in you or I if we do that. Or you or me, I guess. My English teacher would be mad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, me. You or me. Amen. It's supposed to be me. Amen. We don't want to teach people wrong
okay.
grammar, right?
Okay. Me.
Me. You
I don't
me.
Know if you're asking the wrong
No,
person.
It's right.
Okay.
We can get into it, but that's for another day.
Okay.
Amen. He's not going to put worms into you and me, maybe.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I don't know. But here's the thing. Herod was eaten from the inside out.
Yes.
And when we try to take God's glory, we'll get eaten from the inside out, not by worms, but by something called pride.
Yes, yes.
See? Because mm-hmm. pride will begin to rise up on the inside of us.
And
over time, no question, as sure as it destroyed Herod, it will end up destroying us. We'll get eaten from the inside out through pride.
Yes.
Because we refuse to give God the glory
yes.
for his goodness being revealed through our lives.
Amen.
It's a dangerous thing.
That's it.
Amen. God tells us, you know, that, you know, when we're pride, you know, that destruction
right.
follows.
Pride
amen.
Comes before a fall,
That's right.
right.
That's right. So
That's it.
We have to be very, very careful with this. God is serious about this.
Yes.
Amen.
And go
no, go ahead.
And it's nothing wrong with saying thank you.
Right.
You know, we should always be thankful for everything, because it says in everything, give thanks. But give thanks to God.
Amen.
That's the whole point.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Just
right.
we have to realize that it's God's doing. God deserves Mm-hmm. Thank you. God deserves the praise. Amen. God did it. God is good. That's why I'm able to do this. God is good. That's why Amen. I'm able to do this, because God is good. Amen. And the whole thing about, you know, trying to receive God's glory, we're not designed to receive God's glory.
No, we're not.
We're not designed to receive praise that way. We're not formed that way, because we were made for God's glory.
Right.
So we cannot actually receive it. You know, I was thinking about a time when I used to design things, and someone called and I made this program, and they were just so pleased and so happy with it. And they called and they called me, and they were just praising me, and it just felt, it was overwhelming to me. I could not handle it. I fell to my knees. And I said, oh no, thank God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God did this. God did this. We're just not designed to receive God's glory.
Well, right, to receive that. And you're making an excellent point, because we're not designed for it, because we're not supposed to get it.
That's it, exactly.
That's why, but we're not supposed to get it.
We're not supposed to get it.
So we're not designed for
it.
But how many, you know, if you get things that you're not made to receive, it can destroy you.
Yes.
It can destroy you. And that's why this is so very important, that we get this thing, you know, that we get this thing, because it will keep us humble. And God, you know, resists the proud, but He gives grace to the humble.
Amen.
And as we humble ourselves under His hand, He said, I'll exalt you in due time. God is not, you see, this is the thing. God is not against you blowing up.
Amen.
Right?
Yes.
But part of the sevenfold promise He made to Abraham is, I'll make your name great.
Yes.
But He said, I'll do it,
not you.
Right.
Amen.
You don't need to be putting your plaster in your face all over the internet and saying, look at what I did, look how much preaching I did.
Look at me.
Do it so that someone can be edified through the goodness of God, through the workings of God in your life.
Amen.
But, you know, it's like when Peter and Paul, at various times, people came to them and they bowed down to them.
Yes.
And they said, no, we're but a man. And then when John the Revelator tried to worship the angel said, see thou doest not.
Don't do that to me.
Right? Don't treat me like that. That's how we have to be. When people try to give us the glory, we got to say, see thou doest not. No.
Amen.
You give the glory unto
God.
Amen. We give the glory unto God. And again, I think when we begin to live this way, it's going to change us. And it's going to allow God to continue to use us in greater and greater ways, because now He knows we're not trying to rob Him of His glory.
Amen.
Amen. Because see, if He knows that you're a glory robber, right? He's not going to give you opportunities now, because see, now you just take it all for yourself.
Amen.
But when you say, glory to God,
Jesus,
He now knows you're a man and a woman I can trust.
Amen.
And I'm going to give you more and more opportunities. I'm going to give you a greater platform. I believe one of the reasons why now we see some of the more prominent preachers starting to take a fall is because some of them are too busy taking glory that doesn't belong to them.
Amen. It's not about them.
So I think we have to really get this thing. And we don't have to be a big time preacher in order to get it. Amen. In everything you do,
everything,
do it to the glory of God. Do it so that you are walking in agreement with God. If He wants to fill the whole earth with His glory,
Amen.
Then you and I want to say, on my little patch of the earth, I want God to be glorified
Amen.
Right here.
That's it. That's it.
I want His goodness to be revealed right here.
That's it.
And if we do that, now we're walking in agreement with God.
Amen.
And the blessing and the favor and the power of God is going to be with us. Amen.
Amen. And you said it at the beginning. You know, like, we have to, when whatever we're doing, God has to receive the glory from it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And if we know this, we know the word, and we know that God said He wants the whole earth to be filled with His glory, we have to take a moment to ask ourselves, when we're in the midst of something, is this bringing God glory?
Mm-hmm.
And what I'm doing right now, is my lips poked out? Well, I got my lips poked out. Am I giving glory to God in this moment?
No.
No.
Amen. Amen. That's an easy one.
We do. Everything that we Amen. Do, we have to stop and ask ourselves, Amen. Is God getting the glory out of this? Mm. You know, things don't always go to our liking. A lot of things don't go to our liking. Mm-hmm. But the way we respond in those things can give God glory.
No question.
And we just have to be mindful of that, especially as Christians, as His children.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That we are His glory vessels.
Amen.
So we praise God. Listen, we're going to cut this off right about now. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But we praise God for the opportunity to come and to speak about this, because it's so vital, you know, because I think in a lot of ways church and church folk have gone astray.
Yes.
And it's all about God.
Yes.
It's all about God.
It's
not about us. It's Please. Not never. And never has been and never will be
Amen.
About us. It is about God and His goodness. And we want the earth, just like God wants the
yes.
earth, to be filled with the goodness of God, the revelation of God's goodness in the earth. Amen?
Amen.
As truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. So we praise God. We pray you're encouraged by this.
Yes.
Amen. And even yes. though we're not doing the encouraging word anymore, how many of you know all the word is encouraging?
Yes.
And so even though God has us doing a different thing by a different title, we still yet believe and we are praying that it will be encouraging to your spirit. Amen.
Amen.
And we encourage you to walk closer with God, align with His purpose for your life.
Yes.
Amen. So we're going to sign off now, and we're going to keep saying what we always say, amen, because it is so true and it just burns in our heart.
Yes.
Until next time, remember, Jesus loves you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And His love never fails. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Glory to God.
In His eyes, that I'm more precious than gold, loving me.